Hello everybody. So the purpose of this video is to show you how to schedule a Microsoft Teams video conference meeting, how to invite a parent either by their email or even by their phone. So the first thing you need to do is go to your Clever. You're gonna click on the Office 365 app. If you don't see it, just search for it, but mine is on my favorites, so I'm gonna click on Office 365. Now, we're not going into Teams, because if you go straight into Teams, you can really only connect with people you work with. So we are actually gonna start on Outlook. So click on Outlook. If you look on this left-hand side, your email opens up, but on this left-hand side, if you scroll down, there should be a little rectangle that's a calendar, and it even says calendar. So I'm gonna zoom in there so you can see it. You need to click on that calendar. A calendar is going to open up. You might see your school events, your meetings that you've been invited to, and a bunch of different things. That's okay. We're creating a new event. So on this left top-hand corner, we're gonna hit new event. We need to add a title. So I'm gonna act like I'm inviting a parent to this meeting. So I'm gonna say parent meeting, but you can call it whatever you want. Invite attendees. This is where you will input the parent's email address. So for the purpose of this video, I'm gonna use my personal email address and I'm gonna put it right there. So I invited myself, but you would put the parent's email here or whoever you're inviting. You can invite multiple people. I'm gonna set a date. So let's set the meeting for, let's set it for today, and we're gonna set it for 6:10 so that I can demonstrate for you how you'll run that meeting. So I set my day, my time. I'm gonna add a disclaimer here. If you haven't yet noticed, Microsoft Teams conference links seem to not expire. They seem like they don't expire unless you discard them manually. Because I created links for my students to meet with me over 2 weeks ago, and despite the end time that I put, those links are still active. So just for something for you to think of, and if your links do disappear at this time, I'm sorry, I'm not trying to mislead you, but I did create links for my students 2 weeks ago that do still work. But anyways, you'll put in your start time, your finish time. If it's a weekly or daily meeting, you can actually make it repeat, which would be great if you're meeting with that parent or student on a certain day each week or something. But if it's not repeating, you can write never. So where it says search for a room or location, look at this right-hand side. See where it says add online meeting? You're gonna drop down. See where it says Teams meeting? We're gonna hit Teams. This is how the Teams link will be inserted into the meeting appointment. You can set a reminder so it can remind you however long before that meeting you like, and you can add a description. I'm just gonna put a smiley face, but you can add whatever you want. You can add the purpose of the meeting. You can add a PDF that you want somebody to read before the meeting, whatever you need to do. So anyways, I titled my meeting, I added my parent, I set the date, I set the time, and if you're confused about what I said about the link expiring, please disregard that. Just set the time that you need and the time you want it to end, that's okay. I don't wanna confuse anybody or mislead anybody. You can have it repeat or not. Most important part though, search for a room or location. You're not adding anything here. You're gonna go right over to the side, drop down, Teams, add your description, and we are gonna send. So what happens when I send this link, this email, is that the parent in their personal email or the email they provided you is going to get the Teams link. All they'll have to do on the day and time of the scheduled meeting is click on the link to join the chat. So I'm gonna hit send. Now look what happens. If we look at April 8th, my parent meeting is now on my schedule. So pretty cool. So let's say it's April 8th and I'm ready to meet with that parent. It's time to meet. But let's say I'm starting in Clever all over again. I'm going to show you all the way from the beginning. So you want to go to Office 365. You want to go to Outlook. You want to go to your calendar button. Remember, we need to see the calendar. You're going to click on the day and time you have that meeting with that parent. It should show up because we scheduled it. And now when you click on a day and time, or when you click on a day, I'm sorry, that day highlights over here and shows you all of the events for that day. So I had a meeting earlier today, so that's still showing up for today. But there's my parent meeting. It says join Teams meeting. All you need to do to meet with that parent at that day and time is click on Join Teams Meeting. It will ask you to open it in the Microsoft Teams application. This is a personal choice. If you don't want to download the app, you can hit Cancel and you can just write or hit Continue on this browser. So once you do that, it brings you to the meeting. If you want your camera on, then the button will look purple next to it. If you don't want your camera to be on with the parent, you can actually shut the camera by just clicking on that button. See how it turned black? So again, the camera can be on, the camera can be off. I'm thinking you probably want your microphone on when you're meeting with the parent. However, if you ever needed to turn it off, same concept, just click on it, it turns black. Click on it again, it turns purple. That means it's on. So I'm gonna turn my camera and microphone on for the purpose of this video. You can see me. Hi, everybody. I'm gonna hit join now. I'm joining the parent meeting I created. So now I joined, it's open. The parent did not join yet because the parent would need to go into their email and click on that link that I sent them. Once they click on that link, a box will come up that will say, parent, whatever their name is, parent wants to be admitted to the meeting, and you will have two options to admit them or to not admit them. You are going to hit the check mark that says admit. So if the parent finally called in through that link you sent, you would just hit admit, and then they should come up and you'll be able to chat. If for whatever reason the parent didn't get the email, the link's not working, things happen, that's okay. There's actually a really cool backup I wanna show you guys. So say your parent can't get in, or say they just wanna call you on their cell phone, but you don't wanna give them your personal cell phone number, which is completely understandable. You're gonna come down to this bar. So if you move your mouse over the chat, this bar comes up. That's turning your camera on and off, turning your microphone on and off, screen sharing, some other options. You can open the chat, but we don't need the chat right now. So see where these two people are that says show participants? You're gonna click on that, okay? And now you can actually invite someone into the chat. So if that parent couldn't get on or they wanna call from your cell phone and their cell phone instead, sorry, I'm mumbling all of my words, been doing a lot of online teaching this week. Invite someone or dial a number. So you can actually type in the parent's cell phone number. So for the purpose of this video, I'm gonna call my cell phone number just so you guys can see that it actually works. So I just typed in my number. I'm protecting my privacy, but once I typed in the number, I'm gonna click on the number. And once I do, it's gonna say calling. And if you look at my phone, that is showing up. That's me calling from Teams. And that's not my real number. So it leaves my number anonymous. So pretty cool that you can actually call them, and when they see the number on their phone, it's not gonna be your personal cell phone number. It will be a Microsoft Teams number. So it's protecting your privacy. So again, let's just kind of recap what we did in this video. We went to Clever. We opened up the Office 365 app. We went into Outlook. When we got into Outlook, we clicked on our calendar. We created a new event. We created a link to our video chat, and we invited the parents by putting in their email when it asked for participants. We set it up, it shows up in our calendar, and when we're ready to join, there'll be a button on the side of your screen under the correct date. and the time that says Join Teams Meeting. Once you click on it, you can go right through the browser. It brings you to this Teams meeting. And remember what I said, the parent will either join your meeting by clicking on that link in their email, or if there's a problem and they can't do it, you can go to Show Participants, you can type in their email or their cell phone number, and you can invite them again, or you can call them anonymously. So this will really be great for any conferencing you want to do with parents if you don't feel comfortable giving them your personal cell phone number. I really, really hope this video was helpful. Please let me know. And if there's any other things you guys need help with Teams, I'm happy to make another video. Thanks.